Vor über Liebe geredet. We talked about love, but there's another side of love. There is sex. Yes, sex. I know that you, when you were younger, you worked in the sex shop of your dad. Did that change your view of love?
No, not really, not really. I kind of like, I consider that the porn industry is really far away from love.
Right, but what were your experiences then?
Well, it was just a normal salesman job, you know. You were just, instead of selling bananas, you were selling dildos and stuff like that. It's quite nice, you know.
Do you have that stuff at home?
Hmm?
Do you have that stuff at home?
No. Not at the moment. I have it in my bag here. We're on tour anyway.
Oh, you're on tour? How could I forget? Would you ever go back to work there? Or is it over for you?
Yeah, whenever I lose my voice completely and then become fat, old and ugly and stuff like that, then probably I will continue the legacy.
What's the most important thing for you in your music?
The most important is the spirit. The spirit that fills you, that makes you do that, is actually quite close to religion, at least in my place, or even probably in our place too.
I know that you have a tattoo on your arm. Yeah, well, but one of them was an accident because you promised it when you were drunk. What happened there exactly?
That was one story. You know, I can't remember how it happened really. I met a guy who's now a really good friend of mine. Actually, he used to play guitar for us for a while. And he's a really good tattoo artist, and then it just happened. You know. That was the first one I had.
Could you show it? Oh, that's beautiful.
That was the first.
It's again love.
Always about love, you know. Our fixation of hearts, you know. I have collect everything in shape of a heart, you know. Ashtrays and, you know, pillows and pieces of art. You know. Yeah.
Well, I don't know much about Finland, but I know you have very tough winters there. How do you survive that time?
When you come to Switzerland.
Sunbath, you know, in a thing called solarium. You just go into that machine and it gives you sunlight and vitamin D.
Or you just eat a lot of sweets, because when I were there, I just saw so much shops with sweets.
Problem, you know, image-wise. The sweets are so good in Finland that this happens, actually. You get all swollen and nobody believes that you're a vampire.
Well, now you've reached the top. What is next step for you? What do you dream of?
Can't wait the tour to start. Really, in a couple of days, we'll be playing loads of gigs throughout Europe and still doing loads of promotion. Loads of sleepless nights. That's brilliant, you know. I want to keep the whole thing going.
In April, you're gonna play here. What do you expect from the Swiss audience here?
Oh, well, to be there, hopefully. So you can't really expect.
They will, I'm sure. I will be there, so the other will be there.
Well, yeah, that's you can't expect anything. You know, you just have to do your best and hope that it pleases people. Just, I don't want to expect anything.
Hello, my name is Ville Hermanni Romanivalo, and this is...
You.
We come from a band called Him, and...
And you're watching Swiss Music Television.
Ooh la la.